Welcome back to Tipsy Whiskey Shenanigans. I'm Steven, and today, tonight, whenever the heck you're watching this, we have another head-to-head. We have an American single malt battle from the Northwest. We have Westward American Single Malt going up against Westland American Single Malt. Which one is better? We got a great head-to-head on our hands today. We have two American single malts that are both roughly around $65 in most areas going up against each other. They're both really low proof or lower proof. This Westward American Single Malt, which is from Oregon, it is 90 proof. And then we have Westland, which is from Seattle, Washington, at 92 proof. So they're both lower proof, same price, and they're both from the Pacific Northwest. Which one is going to be better? And if you want more specifics on either of these bottles, I'll go ahead and pin their links up here at some given time. You'll see them pop up. But let's just get into that blind. And just like every other blind, I have two Glencairns in front of me, one labeled A, one labeled B. I do not know which one is which. I have a key to the side, so we're gonna go ahead and get into these with the nose palette finish and then grade them, kind of see which one's better. And let's just start off with what the heck's in Glencairn A on the nose. Very chocolatey, malty, earthy. Nice little like pear, like red apple, kind of like pineapple almost note, but also very like chocolatey, earthy, a little bit of leather, some nice oak. Very, very like, it's like malty, like it's chocolate maltiness, but also still a nice little bit of like a citrusy forward kind of lighter fruits, like a pear, pineapple type going on. Let's go ahead and get onto the nose of Glencairn B. Ooh, this one's more brown sugar forward. Brown sugar, a little lighter, more vibrant. Definitely getting pineapples on this. A little bit of like a honey-covered grilled pineapple. This one's more sweeter, like very much so like vanilla, caramel, brown sugar forward, and a nice like coffee note. Yeah, very, very sweet. This is very heavy. It's still that same, like, just definitely like malty, chocolate, coffee note, but it's so much sweeter, heavy brown sugars, caramels, vanillas, and a nice, like, honey, pear, pineapple note. Little bit of red fruits, kind of like a plum almost. I'm really digging on both of these notes. Let's go ahead and get on the palate, starting off with Glencairn B. Ooh, herbaceous, slightly vegetal, very black tea, peppery, clove, pineapple for sure, green apples, nice honey, vanilla, brown sugars, coffee for sure, and almost like a slight hint of like a white chocolate almost. Yeah, it's very herbaceous, earthy, dark, a little bit of leather, nice like coffee, toffee, chocolatey note towards the finish. And a nice like fruity pineapple, kind of like almost like citrus, like lemony note all the way through as well. Very, very good. Let's go ahead and check out the palate of Glencairn A. Light roast coffee, a little bit of oat milk, slight hint of like a chocolatey syrup. Yep, that's exactly it. It's very malty, chocolate, coffee, and very like, what is that? Like a vanilla note in there? Ooh, yeah. That's like chocolate malted milk, coffee, ooh. It's like you made coffee, but then you put like chocolate oat milk in it. That's exactly what it is. That's, ooh. And finish is very like chocolatey. Chocolatey, chocolatey, coffee, toffee, little bit of oak, a slight like apple fruitiness throughout all of it. This is a close one. I don't know which one of these I like better. They're both same, but different, but still same. So Glencairn B, it's a little bit more vibrant, fruitier, citrus, less dark, dense notes, where A is super dark, roasted, chocolate, maltiness. It's like dark and earthy. B, lighter, vibrant, more bright. Overall, I'm gonna have to give it to Glencairn A. I mean, Glencairn A is just a little bit better in my opinion. I know, I'm personally the kind of person who really likes the darker, earthier flavors, and that's A in the nutshell. I think A is phenomenal. It's very dark, roasted coffee, chocolate, and just brown sugars, a little bit of leathery note, very malty. It's like malted milkshake, or like a malted milkshake that you used as like your coffee creamer in a way. I know that doesn't make any sense, but you know what I'm saying. Where A is, it is more vibrant. So if you're someone who likes lighter flavor profiles, I'm sure B's more of your go-to flavor profile, but for me, I'm gonna have to go Glencairn A is the winner just because of that flavor profile, that dark, dense earthiness on there. Let's go ahead and figure out which one is which, because I'll be honest, I tried both of these yesterday for the first time ever, so I haven't really had any time to like actually like normalize and figure out what these actually are and what they taste like. So let's just get into it. And Glencairn A, the winner is Westland American Single Malt Whiskey from Seattle, Washington. This stuff's really freaking good. I really, really like it. And I think this is the winner because, well, I mean, obviously I like just the darker, earthier flavor profiles, but I know this has like a chocolate malt in it, and I think that's what makes this an exceptional, like nuanced, exciting whiskey. Whereas this, it's more of a traditional kind of American single malt whiskey, which again, not talking crap on this at all. These are both fantastic, fantastic whiskeys. I really like both of these, and at $65, you can't lose. This is more traditional. So if you're looking to get into an American single malt, even though I do think this is the better single malt in my opinion, check out Westward. Westward has a more traditional, like approachable, inclusive type flavor profile, where Westland is very, very chocolatey, malty. So if you're someone who doesn't like that flavor profile, you probably won't like this. Me, I'm a sucker for dark, dense, like chocolatey coffee flavor. So this is like, this might be my new favorite American single malt. Whereas this is your traditional American single malt done right at a really well price. So I think this is overall a better inclusive, like starting off American single malt, where Westland, I think, is a more nuanced kind of dark, dense flavor profile. But that being said, I do like Westland a little bit more than Westward. But if we're gonna be honest, you can't go wrong with either. They're both fantastic, fantastic American single malts. And if you're looking to get into the American single malt world and you have the availability to pick both of them up, do so. You'll thank yourself later. They're just different American single malts. And I go for dark, dense flavors, which is, well, no surprise, even remotely. No surprise at all. That's gonna be a wrap for this video though. Please do me a favor, like, comment, subscribe. Do yourself a favor, pick up both of these American single malts. Also, let me know what American single malts you think could beat Westland or even Westward, because honestly, it was very, very close. Also, check out the Instagram, Facebook, and the Patreon. The link for that is down there below. Cheers, y'all. We'll see you later.